Ever since I heard of Ekranoplans, I've wanted to attempt building my own radio-controlled version. I believe that building one from foam would be boring because other YouTubers have already done so, and foam is fairly simple to work with. And so I decided to challenge myself by designing, printing, and building a fully 3D printable Ekranoplan using a similar technique to my 3D printed RC plane design. You should check that video out, by the way. If you guys don't already know what an Ekranoplan is, it's basically a plane-like boat thing that was developed in the Soviet Union during the Cold War. This type of vehicle uses a phenomenon called the ground effect in order to hover a few meters above the water's surface. This allowed the Ekranoplan to reach speeds upwards of 500 kilometers an hour, which is pretty wild. Anyways, I know that you didn't come here for a history lesson, so I've linked a great video all about Ekranoplans down below. Alright, so I've already printed all the parts, so let's just get right to the build. Okay, so the plane is almost finished. All of the controls are working. So in mode one, you just have the normal controls, elevator,
rudder,
aileron, and throttle. Now, I wasn't sure about how much spacing it needs above the water, because I don't know how much it will actually sink into the water. So in that case, I added flaps on a switch. And that will just allow me to adjust the lift. I got the 8-channel receiver. All of these wires go to the servos and motors. What I'm going to do is close it up and somehow waterproof it. That's the hard part. I don't know how to make this waterproof. But we'll see. Now it's really late in the night and tomorrow is the perfect day for test flying this. So I'm gonna have to get all of this done right now. Go to bed, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. All right, so I did a few modifications overnight on this Ekranoplan. I covered the bottom with a silicone sealant and then rubber cement and then finally this reflective aluminum tape. I have really low hopes for this, it's probably gonna leak. And yeah, I'm going to try this. This is probably one of my most frustrating projects of all time. It all started with the motor, which would start making weird noises and glitch out at higher speeds.
This is so stupid.
Also, the Ekranoplan sat way too close to the water, which did not allow it to gain any speed. In fact, some of the water was actually able to flow over the wings, which was not good. The waterproofing also seemed to have no effect since water easily got into the plane.
It's doomed just like the original.
Okay, come on.
No!
I also had very limited control over the steering. You see, the rudder was too small and not enough air hit it, so I actually had to use the flaps on the wings to steer instead.
This is so terrible.
Rudder,
come back.
Luckily, I was able to return the Ekranoplan to shore, but the project was a major disappointment and seemed to be a big waste of time. Feeling defeated, I decided to fly my Sea Duck, which is a seaplane that I've had a lot of luck with, but that did not go well either.
Oh, that did not. Oh, that's sinking. Oh, she's sinking.
Oh, she's going. Oh, go on, go on, go on, go on. Yeah.
Come on!
You can do this! Ah! Oh!
Let's use the battery!
cut myself.
The day was a total failure and morale was low, but I did not want to give up just yet.
Alright, so I've done so much to this thing since the last test. I've added these two motors in the front, which are angled downwards to provide lift for the nose and just to provide extra power so that it can actually, you know, go. I have these redesigned floats on both sides, and I added this bottom portion to improve performance and raise it above the surface of the water. Flaps are working as usual, and yeah, it's just better balanced. Now I have to deal with this just terrible wire mess. So, see you guys at the lake.
Okay, so the weather's finally cooperating. It's been pretty nasty the past couple of weeks, which is the reason why I haven't been able to release a video for quite a while. Now, I did do some tests beforehand with the Ekranoplan just on the ground to see if the motors have enough power to break the friction force. And they definitely do. The thing has a lot of punch to it. And of course, it drains the battery pretty quickly. At one point it was actually too fast and it lifted up and the tail section basically broke off. So what I did was I added some skewers onto the tail to reinforce it. And I'm excited to see how it's going to go. Let's do this.
I hit a f***ing stick. See this? F***ed.
Basically what happened was this little twig was on the road at a speed of 20 kilometers an hour. My board just suddenly just halted and projected me forwards onto the ground. I'm not sure what state my equipment is in. I think it's fine. I want to get this project just over with already, so I'm going to go home and glue together all of the bits and hopefully I'll be able to recover it.
Okay, so finally here and ready to try this Ekranoplan. Water is kind of wavy, but I hope it's not going to be too much of a problem. Got the Mavic up there. And ready to go.
Whoa.
Guys, I don't think I'm going to be able to recover it. It's floating away. I'm trying to get it with my drone just by redirecting air, but
It's just not budging. It's just going offshore more and more, so... I guess this is a loss.
So, what have I learned? Well, it turns out that ekranoplans are more complicated than I initially thought. Although my design did glide across the water semi-well, it still had many underlying issues.
Definitely not watertight.
I'm not even sure if I got it into the ground effect. I think I made it too small. Any small factors like waves or wind affected it greatly. And in the future, I'd make it bigger. When it went fast enough, it would jump with the nose and eventually fly up. And that led to its death. I think the design could have been further improved to prevent the bouncing of the nose, but honestly, I've lost so much motivation at this point that I'm just glad this project is over with. For those of you who are wondering, I did attempt to recover the ekranoplan, but sadly, I failed at that. Anyways, I'm going to share the files for free in the description, should you decide to build one. So I guess that's it for this project. Anyways, guys, if you enjoyed this video, make sure to leave a like because that helps promote my videos on YouTube. And if you want more content like this, make sure to subscribe. This project took so long and so much effort, and my back still hurts from that longboard accident. So, see you guys next time. We'll be right back.